In this video, we will talk about pressure in the aorta during a cardiac cycle. Let's get started with a quick revision of pressure in the left ventricle during a cardiac cycle. We will start our discussion with the systole. At this point, all the valves are closed and ventricular pressure is on the lower side. Now, the ventricles contract as closed chambers. This produces a sharp rise in the pressure. Then aortic valve opens and there will be a rapid ejection of blood. During this, the pressure keeps rising and reaches a maximum level. The maximum pressure that the left ventricle achieves is about 120 mmHg. Then the ejection is slowed down, so pressure starts falling. Then the aortic valve closes and diastole begins. During diastole, pressure first falls and then gradually starts rising. The next cycle begins with systole. So this is how pressure change occurs in the left ventricle. Now during this part, the aortic valve is open and ventricle is pumping blood into the aorta. So to understand the aortic pressure, this part is very important. On that note, let's see the pressure in the aorta now. At the beginning of the ventricular systole, the pressure in the aorta is about 80 mmHg. At the end of the isovolumetric contraction, the aortic valves open and ventricles push blood into the aorta. So pressure in the aorta rises. With continued ejection, the pressure in the aorta gets even higher than that in the ventricle. Look here, the curve for the aorta has crossed and gone above the curve for the ventricle. Thus, at this point, the pressure in the aorta is actually higher than that in the ventricle. Now, there is an interesting thing to understand here. In spite of this increased pressure in the aorta, the aortic valve does not close yet. This is because of the inertia of the blood flow. Ventricular pumping has imparted considerable kinetic energy to the blood. And this forward-moving blood does not allow the valves to close for a while. Eventually though, the ejection gets slower and blood flow also gets slower. So pressure in the ventricle as well as the aorta starts falling. Now due to higher pressure in the aorta, the blood flow actually reverses direction late in the ejection phase. Means it flows from aorta to the ventricles. This immediately causes the closure of the aortic valve. Then the blood again starts flowing in the forward direction. The pressure recording during all this looks like this. The backflow of the blood produces a notch in the curve. At this point, the aortic valve closes. And then as blood again moves forward, there is an upward deflection in the pressure curve. This notch due to backflow is called a diacrotic notch or incisura. So this was all during systole and early part of the diastole. Later in the diastole, the blood in the aorta keeps flowing forward. So pressure gradually falls. By the end of the diastole, it reaches the lowest value of 80 mmHg. Even this lowest value is also high in aorta because of the elastic recoil of the wall. This, in fact, is helpful to keep the blood moving forward during diastole. This completes one cycle. The next cycle begins with ventricular systole. After isovolumetric contraction, the aortic valves open at this point and there will be a rise in pressure again. So this is aortic pressure during a cardiac cycle. The pressure curve in the pulmonary artery is similar, but the values are lower. The minimum pressure in the pulmonary artery is about 7 mmHg and the maximum pressure is about 25 mmHg. This was all the detail. Now let's have a quick summary. At the beginning of the ventricular systole, the aortic pressure is at its lowest point. With the opening of the aortic valve and ejection of blood, the pressure in the aorta increases. It even exceeds the pressure in the ventricle, but the inertia of the blood keeps the aortic valve open for a while. Then with decreased ejection, the pressure starts falling. Towards the end of the ejection phase, the backflow of the blood produces a diacrotic notch. During diastole, the blood keeps moving forward, so there is a gradual fall in the pressure. The next cycle begins with the next systole. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.